There's been a murder, and I can think of only one woman to crack the case. The name Slaughter, Karin Slaughter.
Best-selling crime author turned Netflix producer Karin Slaughter joins us now to discuss her latest case, Girl Forgotten. Thank you so much, Karin, for joining us this morning. You're one of my favourite crime writers, I have to say. I do really enjoy your books, and I really love this one now because I think it could be next in your big, big series. Where did your love of crime novels come from, or your crime writing?
Well, you know, I was a little girl who loved reading and loved hearing stories, and it felt like a natural thing for me to write my own stories. And since I'm the youngest of three girls, most of my earlier works were about my sisters being kidnapped or mutilated, or they just disappear. They were happy endings because I was an only child. And my dad loved these books. He thought they were hilarious. So he would give me a quarter every time I wrote one. So very early on, I was incentivized to write murder stories.
Wow. I've got five sisters. I know exactly how I feel. Like, I wish I had your skills, though, when it comes to that sort
That's
of
incredible.
Stuff.
You had your first publishing deal for a quarter a book. That's not bad.
No. I mean, consider inflation.
In terms, like, when you look back and you talk about this is like book number 21, in terms of your writing, you do like to include, you do like to keep your writing, you know, you write very contemporary, like you include things like the pandemic, etc. In terms of your process, Karin, over the years from book one to the latest book, how has that process evolved or has it changed?
You know, I came up with Mark Billingham and John Collette. And we often say to each other, when is it going to get easier, right? The more you do something, the better you're supposed to get at it. And it's not easy. Every time we start a book, we want to say something different and new and interesting. And, you know, all of us are aware of the books we've written before. We want our readers to be happy and to love the twists and turns. So that's really the challenge, is coming up with a new way to tell the story and, you know, to keep it relevant to the reader. A lot of things I've been writing about for many years are now considered political, you know, like women shouldn't be raped and sexual violence is a bad thing. You know, that's suddenly in the United States become a politicized kind of way of writing. But I think you just write the story you want to read. And I want to know more about women and how they deal with this sort of stuff and how the good guys in their lives help them respond to it.
Yeah. Your latest book, Girl Forgotten, I have to say, I thought it was a slight departure from a lot of your previous subject matter in that it took on something that I think you alluded to it there. I mean, yes, sexual assault, the way women are treated. And this storyline is particularly bleak because it comes from the tragic murder of a girl many, many years ago. And you kind of leap back and forth between timelines and her group of friends that she thought were her friends and who was responsible for her death ultimately. What did you draw on to get that particular group, that particular storyline? Because I found it quite fascinating compared to your other works.
You know, I think we all can relate to horrible high school experiences. And I don't want to say I stole from Maeve Binchy's Circle of Friends. It's more like Circle of Friends if Dante did it.
Yeah.
But Emily Vaughn is a teenage girl, and she's had these particular friends in her clique since she was in kindergarten. And, you know, we often forget that people being canceled is not a new thing. It's just more amplified because of the internet. So she kind of gets canceled in her school because she did something that broke this unwritten social contract. She went from being a good girl to a quote unquote bad girl. And I think that we all can relate to that fear of isolation, particularly given the pandemic, right? Where we've all been locked away like inmates. And so I wanted to talk a little bit about that kind of isolation and the feeling that your world can completely change in 1 minute. I mean, of all the things I've ever written about, that kind of shocking, sudden change, I think, is the scariest.
Yeah.
Karin, can we talk about pieces of her? When I was at home yesterday and I knew you were coming on the show today, I was talking to my wife and she was asking me who's on, and I said, Karin Slaughter, and I said, pieces of her. And she sat bolt upright. She thought that series was phenomenal. She was glued to it. She's a huge Toni Collette fan, but loved the show. Can we talk about that becoming, you know, going from the book to the show? Can you talk to us about that process and how involved were you? Because you were involved as a producer on the show, is that right?
I was, yeah. And, you know, I wasn't like a top producer, but they listened to me, which was nice. We're in that part of television where suddenly they're like, oh, wait, the author actually knows about the story. They know about the characters. So they were really generous using me as a resource for what was going on in the characters' minds in certain scenes. And that was really great. And, you know, Toni Collette is amazing. She's just a remarkable actress, a remarkable person. One of the things I thought was really funny was we all did a press junket together and people were panicking because she didn't have all the material she needed. And she said, you know what, screw it. We'll just play it by ear. And I thought, that's why everybody loves Toni Collette. You know, she's not a diva.
One of the things that Lisa said to me about the show was, because I hadn't seen the show, but she was explaining it to me. She said what she loved about it was that it just started with a bang. You were straight into the story. There was no, you know, long, slow build-up. She described the opening couple of scenes to me, and she said it just started with an explosion and absolutely had you hooked from the start.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of like in Girl Forgotten when I talk about Emily Vaughn. It's very unfortunate she's in the first chapter of a Karin Slaughter novel because you know things aren't going to go well.
Yeah. But this same character, who's the main character in Girl Forgotten, now she was in pieces of her as well, Andrea Oliver. I love her, actually. She's brilliant. Are we going to have that maybe, not a sequel, but yes, a sequel series to Pieces of Her? And will it be based on this Girl Forgotten? Have you been in talks for anything like that just yet?
You know, they haven't said anything about it. When they do a limited series, they say it's limited. But, I mean, who knows? If the book does well. So we need everyone in Ireland to rush out and get it now if they want to see the sequel. But, you know, I love the book. I hope people really enjoy it. It was a lot of fun to write. And I love the character of Andrea. I think she just has such an important story to tell.
And thank you very much, by the way, for leaving the book on a massive cliffhanger, because I was like, oh, this is going to wrap up nicely for me. But no, it doesn't. Yeah. The sequel to this book is going to be explosive, I just know, because there's a baddie. There's a baddie in it that is beyond evil, beyond anything you can even see. And the appetite for the third book is there. When can we expect the next installment?
Well, I have to write it, but aww, my next one will be in my Will and Sarah series, so I hope people are happy with that. But definitely there are more stories for Andrea coming up. Yeah.
In terms of television and Netflix, I mean, you know, in terms of going forward and your writing, would that influence your writing at all, Karin, in terms of would you be more inclined now to write something with the intention maybe of ending up on a small screen or big screen?
You know, I can't think about that. The books are the books and the show is the show. And, you know, I love writing and I love being the boss of the book. And, you know, this guy's from being in television. It's a very collaborative sort of way of working. Yeah. It's not just you getting to have the final say. So I like being a book writer, and I'll leave the script writing to people who are better at collaborating than me.
So tell me about, you say Will and Sarah there. I know they're the main characters in your other two series, which have like converged into the one storyline now, I believe. What is your next book for Will Trent and Sarah Linton? Where are they going to next?
You know, I can't give too much away, but
a little
occasionally
bit.
I'll focus on one versus the other. And this is a very Sarah-centric book. And I'm pretty excited about the story. We learned some new things about her, which is kind of remarkable considering I've been writing about her for over 20 years. So I hope people enjoy it, but it's got a lot of shocks and twists in it.
As they always do.
Listen,
Karin, it's been lovely to chat with you and catch up with you and continue success with everything you do.
Thank you so much. I hope to be in Ireland doing this in person next year.
Well, I hope to see you then.
Elaine, while you're sitting on the couch beside her, she's bringing all your books.
Pick
Thanks,
your brains.
Karin.